Composition is one of the most important factors in the success or failure of your art. You may create a work that is executed at the highest level of technical skill, but if your composition is weak, then your art is too. In this lesson, we will explore a compositional theory that will help you. This compositional theory is called the rule of third. The rule of third is best understood by analyzing a blank surface. This could be a sheet of drawing paper or your canvas. You can divide the picture plan into segments using vertical and horizontal line. You will notice that the horizontal and vertical lines intersect. These locations of intersection are excellent places to position important element within your composition. For example, you may place the focal point on one of these intersecting points in order to create a more successful composition. Studies shows that placing object in these intersections creating a pleasing composition. The rule of third is actually a guideline more than a rule. Let's take a few practical examples. In our first example, we will take a look at a landscape. I place the main object at the center. According to this rule, you should avoid main object at the center point. Let's try to improve this again. As you can see, we have now placed the lighthouse along the right vertical line. The base of the lighthouse is now positioned on one of the intersection points. The rule of thirds is mostly known as a tool for composing landscape. As you can see the difference with this grid line. Let's take an example to a portrait. It breaks an image down into thirds, so you have 9 pieces and 4 grid lines. It is a simple way to improve your composition. Also keep in mind that it's just one composition technique among many. place the eyes on the focal point. The focal point of a picture should be placed along one of the third lines or on one of the four intersections of the third line to give aesthetically pleasing result. Now that you know how to follow the rule, it's important to understand why it matters and what exactly it can do for your drawing. Firstly, by positioning key elements at the focal point, your drawing becomes more balanced. Your key elements create visual interest in a third of the composition. As you can see, the subject is placed directly in the center of the picture plan. Composition that include key element in the center of the frame often feel very static and boring. Let's take some few examples of landscape drawing so that you can better understand of this rule. Thank you. Here I am using 5 sections for this landscape, which is called the positive space. Another example with the same landscape. Here I draw the main object at the center point. And in the second composition, I placed that tree on the focal point, which looked more attractive. So start practicing and watch as your composition improves. According to this rule, you can use any section. Use only 3 sections and 5 sections or 6 sections. It is your choice which type of section you can use. Should not draw attractive thing on the border. Clear all about this rule. Now you can create your own landscape and painting according to the rule of thirds.